Well, howdy, 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 nearly senior citizen here. Greetings, boys and girls, and welcome to this, another brand new day. I move my mouse down, and it is 7.03 a.m. on Tuesday, the 3rd of April, 2018. I'm looking downward because in the chair, between my thighs, scrabbling about on the either leather or faux leather, I don't know, is little Mama Squeak. She was running around because I wanted to show her off. So I put her on my lap and she quickly went off my legs onto the chair and was just wandering around and looking at stuff. No, look this way. Come on. Come on. You can face the other way. You can do it. I got faith in you. She just does not want to face that way. You silly little goose. She's been chewing again, of course, on the plastic in the corner of her bin cage. So I heard her chewing the other day and trying to think of, like, you know, how am I going to keep her from doing that? And it's like, you know, if dogs like to chew on things, you put like Tabasco on the things they chew on. Okay, I'll put you down. She's scraping her teeth on my palm, so I'm going to put her down. And so I put some hot sauce in a spoon. And I brought it to her bin cage and I took her out because I wanted to put it where she was chewing and scrabbling. And then I put the spoon up to her to see what she would do. And she licked it and she sniffed and then licked and then spent some time just going. So I knew she wasn't a big fan of it. So I smeared that hot sauce into the area that she was chewing on. Hopefully it'd keep her away. I think she's chewing on it now because the hot sauce stuff is salty and animals like salt, so she's still chewing on the corner. I don't know what I'm gonna do. She's a monster, but that's okay. And when I brought her out this morning, instead of just lifting up her house, she quickly ran back inside of her little house. I went and knocked on top of her house to let her know that there was something in there. And just scrabbled and scraped through the bedding outside in her cage and knocked up against her little chew toy stuff. And so she came out to identify what the sound was, and that's when I swooped down and grabbed her. But she didn't mind. I mean, she just looked up as my hand came down and then didn't try to escape or run away or panic or anything. Just sat there as I picked her up, so. Wasn't a terrifying thing, and she was used to it. My sincere apologies. I love this. It's, of course, because it's spring and warmer and moist, there's all new sorts of pollen and leaf mold and all fun stuff in the air, and I'm allergic to some stuff. Mild nuisance allergies. The stuff that makes your nose run, that's nuisance allergy. That's your immunoglobulin E latching onto something that's harmless and going ballistic and putting your entire immune system into fighting that harmless thing. I got some in my eye. But that's why it's a nuisance allergy, because your entire immune system is powering down on something that's useless. Good old immunoglobulin E. That's why when you have a cold, it's the same thing. That's actually like a annoyance allergy as well, because what you're fighting when you have a cold, that's what your immune system is doing to get rid of this virus. And the virus is basically harmless. It's just, it enrages your immune system, and everything you're feeling is your immune system. It's not the cold doing it to you. So thumbs up on that. But trying to remember the bread trail crumb of conversation backward, I'm allergic, annoyance, allergy, allergic to leaf mold and such like that. So my sinuses are going crazy. No, I can't. I was able to trace it back that far. Can't remember why I brought that up, but still. I remember I was talking about hamsters and Mama Squeak. I remember when Mama Squeak was born, she was originally called Little Squeak. And then when she had a baby, And Ed had breathing troubles, because she originally had breathing troubles as well. Mama Squeak was originally a runt, and she clicked and squeaked when she breathed, and we were all so afraid that she wasn't going to live. And now she's up and digging in her cage again. She's a mighty and powerful hamster, and she's lived a long time and is continuing to live and has had many batches of babies, and so that is a good thing. But when she had a baby that was a runt that clicked and squeaked, that's when Little Squeak Jr. was born, and Little Squeak Jr. became my favorite, and then, of course, injured herself, was in constant pain, stressed out her system, got wet tail, and died. I imagine that's what happened. She had a spinal injury, and she moved so slow and carefully afterwards. She was probably in constant pain, and being in constant pain stresses you out. And hamsters are high-stress critters, and when you stress them out, their immune system bottoms out. They get wet tail and die. So Little Squeak Jr. became Little Squeak Jr., and Little Squeak became Mama Squeak. So Mama Squeak is still alive, though I don't think I have any of her babies left. Oh well, life is life. Still, hamsters are fun. They're wonderful little critters. I love them. Little Boogle was making little scribbling and scrabbling on plastic sounds, because all of my hamsters are now in bin cages. Once again, thank you so much, Potatotron. A very good thing. And I heard scraping and scrabbling on plastic coming from her cage. And she's got a two-story house that's buried in the bedding in her house. And it was kind of moving when I heard these sounds. And so instead of violating her safe place and lifting up her house, I just lifted up the bin cage and looked underneath to see what she was doing. And for whatever reason, she wasn't chewing on it, but she was like trying to burrow through the plastic. And so she was just scribble, 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 and just going ballistic and having her own little time that way. One of the things you learn as a hamster owner is hamsters gonna hamster, which is just means sometimes you're gonna be able to figure out what they're doing and why they're doing things. And sometimes they just do the weirdest bloody stuff that you can't come up with any reason why they'd be doing that. Well, hamster's gonna hamster. Makes sense to them, and they're gonna do it, like it or not, so you just gotta roll with it and go with the flow. One thing I have tried doing to see if my webcam is going to deal with this better, I had finally recognized that, well, remembered, that my webcam, you can set it to save on whatever hard drive you want. All of my hard drives are super, super slow, and I don't know why. You're supposed to have like 200 megabit per second transfer speeds, and I'm having like a 120 megabit is my fastest, and that's my SSD drive, my C drive. Everything else is around 40 to like 80. And that's really, really super, super slow. But what my webcam was doing was saving to my external drive, which is not the fastest. And I think what would happen is it would get stuff, data would just get caught in the bus, and then the webcam, for whatever reason, just couldn't handle the backlog, would go into still shot mode, freeze frame, and then crash. Today, I got it set so it's saving to my C drive, my SSD. I do have one drive that's a hybrid drive, which is, you know, the hybrid between SSD and regular, but it's like a couple years old now. So it's like older tech. I don't know if they've got better ones. And even it's slow. So, but I have not seen any lag spikes while recording today. So that's a very good thing. A very, very good thing. Definitely a thumbs up. I only talked with my sister a very little bit yesterday. And for whatever reason, of course, you know, cell phones blow. And in Shelton here, cell phone coverage is horrible. When we lived up on Euclid, kitty corner from where my brother-in-law used to live, we couldn't even use cell phones in the house. There was no coverage. only toward the end of my wife's life did they have enough coverage that you could start to use a cell phone in the house, and even then it was iffy. So there's not a lot of good coverage around in here. I can't remember what I was talking about now. Isn't that special? Once again, it's bloody fibromyalgia, depression, and my brain damage from alcoholism of 25. I figured it out. I started drinking before I was even 10, which means that was over 25 years I was drinking. Now, from when I started drinking to when I was about 14, it was sporadic. I wasn't a constant alcoholic. I was just drinking my parents' alcohol to deal with issues because I learned that alcohol worked. I made drinks for my parents because my parents thought it was, you know, interesting to just stay watching TV and then have me make a drink for them, because I didn't mind doing stuff for my parents. I was a kid. And so I'd make them a drink and then I'd bring them their drinks and they drank. So I knew where the liquor cabinet was, and I would go down and raid the liquor cabinet. It was when 14 to when I started high school, first or second year is when things really started ramping up, and I started really drinking hard because I started looking older, could pass as the drinking age of 18 at the time, and drank. I drank everywhere, and I went to conventions and got smashed and drank in the bars. I drank everywhere as often as I could. So by the time I went to the military and they started changing the law so that you were had to be 21 to drink in the United States as opposed to 18, and I was 19, was grandfathered in, I continued just pouring alcohol down my neck as fast as I could. So, yay. Yeah, I wish it was as easy as just going back to my younger self and saying, don't be doing this because you're going to become an alcoholic, because what are you going to tell the 10-year-old child who is suffering and hurting from physical and sexual abuse? How do you explain this is not a good plan, it's going to lead to suffering, when the person, the 10-year-old child, is suffering right there and found something that works? That's a horrible thing for a 10-year-old child to have to do. 10 and younger, to learn how to medicate to get through life. Thumbs up. Life is wonderful. And life is wonderful. I mean, even though my mother has perished, and 4 years ago my wife perished, and people keep dying all around. I mean, I'm not the only one, of course. My stepfather's daughter, oldest daughter, like 10 years ago now, I think, her husband just suddenly fell down dead one day. So she's had to live with being a widow, of having that pain of living inside that big empty house. She's lucky in that being a woman, that usually doesn't kill you. Being a widower usually does. Of course, there are people that survive it. There's outliers of everything, but statistically, men tend not to. Thumbs up. Oh gosh, there was some other stuff I wanted to talk to. In fact, oh yes, this is one thing I wanted to do. That's why I put it here. This is my actual flashlight that I use when I go out walking. I've mentioned this before. It's my walkie's flashlight. I put this little metal thing into my pocket, and then it just hangs from my pocket, and I walk with this going on. And this is a whole bunch. It's got a whole bunch of LEDs that come out of that, 7 of them. There's another one just for whatever reason, if you want to do that. And then, of course, the third click, and it turns them all on. And it's bloody bright, and it's a USB rechargeable, so I just recharge it, pop it onto my pant leg when I go out, and I go walking. And it's got like a hook, so you can hook it on things. Like, I don't. It had a handle, you know, one of those cheap, awful little things that comes apart real quick. And it did. So, but I don't use the hook part for that. One thing I've been thinking of is, you know, self-defense. I'm a guy out there alone by myself. You know, it's like figure out a way to make this so that it stays out all the time, but sharpen it and then paint it brown so that no one can really notice that it's there, so that if I have to, I've got a dangerous spike. So that last, you know, like, and then while they're going, holy smoke, that old guy with the flashlight stabbed me. I'm running away and trying to escape. So we'll find out. Most likely if that would happen, I'd end up dropping it. And then if I did hurt them, they'd then just like shoot me because I hurt them. So, whoa, don't do that. So it's a good flashlight. It was like $20 a couple years back, and I like it. It's just plastic. Oh yeah, it's even got magnets on it. I don't have anything aside from like that. So you can hook it on stuff too. Or I guess if you don't want to get up and you want to pick up something metal. So. Oops. Anyway, though, I've opened up 24 hours worth of comments on my community tab, so I'm going to go through and thank 20 to 25 people. It is arranged because with my fibro depression brain damage, I forget, even though I count in ASL here right in front of my own eyes, I forget. She's chewing on her house. If I mispronounce your username, my sincere apologies. I'm an American English speaker, we're not good at names, and I'm not reading the comments right now. I'm going to go through and read the comments after the video, but for right now, I'm just thanking you for having left a comment. Good comment, bad comment, indifferent comment. The fact is you left a comment. Thank you so very, very much. So first off, we have Get Money. Thank you very, very much. Jack Grieg. Thank you. Greatly appreciated. GT86. Greatly appreciated. Michael. Thank you very, very much. Dino Nuggets. Thank you. Cheska Abad, thank you very, very much. Strat 458796, thank you very, very much. Kira Linham, thank you very much, greatly appreciated. Bomb Smith, thank you. Toxic Barrel, thank you very, very much. Ice Demon, greatly appreciated. Rida Madi, I sure hope that is close, thank you very, very much. Esme YT, thank you very, very much. SKTit, Tom? I sure hope I'm close, though I know I'm not, but thank you very, very much. Victor Romero, greatly appreciated. Tundra Keeper, greatly appreciated, and I certainly hope you're feeling better today. Sean Michael Butler, thank you very, very much. And Fame Paradise, greatly appreciated. Tamjid Umchiha, thank you very much. I sure hope I'm close with your name. I am probably not, but thank you. Official Aaron, thank you. Diana Sykes, greatly appreciated. And ZGHPXX, thank you very, very much. Ataxion, I sure hope I'm close. Thank you very, very much. Gavin Martinez, greatly appreciated. And last but not least, Chewbacki, Chew-B-O-K-K-I-E-E. Thank you very much. That's a funny name. I like that. Greatly appreciated. Each and every one of you, as stated, you get me out of my head, into the real world again, dealing with people. Greatly appreciated. Thank you so very much. Boy, I am still doing a Steam giveaway for Starpoint Gemini 2, so if you put in the phrase Godzilla eats gnomes, I'm having the drawing tomorrow, so still, no fear. And if you could check out my links, I got Twitter, Facebook, GoFundMe, Patreon.com, Google+. It would be awesome if you could donate to my GoFundMe campaign or become a Patreon.com patron like one of these beautiful and awesome people. Thank you so much. But if you cannot donate or you simply do not donate, I take all good wishes, deposit them in the bank of my heart where I draw interest. Thank you very, very much. If you could toss me a like, that would be very cool. I do appreciate all the positive validation I get from my existence. If you could subscribe to the channel, that would be cool, but I would understand if you don't want to. But if you are down with it, I will do my best to keep you entertained from now until the end of time. And remember, hit that little notification button, because otherwise YouTube is not going to let you know when I put out videos, and I put out videos a lot, so maybe you don't want to. I'm not sure. Anyway, I'd love to advertise my Humble Bundle thing, but I can't. No time. Go visit anyway. So you take care. I'm a terrible salesman. Have a great day today. I will see you on the flip side. See, I can smile.